Welcome to Crewe, located in the northwest of England. Step back in time and discover the soot and sounds of the steam era. Climb aboard iconic living locomotives hungry for coal and water, and work hard on busy passenger and freight services through historic Merseyside and Cheshire. There's an empty poster over there. Fix that while you're here. There are more tasks to find. Be sure to refill sand buckets, fill coal sacks, place travel posters and light braziers. Follow the markers to board the train before departure. Take a seat in first class. You can sit in any available seat.
You can pause the experience at any point and review previous and current objectives. Check it out now and then return to the game when ready.
This train is powered by an LMS Jubilee class steam locomotive. These were built between 1934 and 1936 and originally nicknamed Red Stanniers because of their original crimson livery, but later earned the nickname Jubilee when one of their class was named Silver Jubilee in recognition of the Silver Jubilee of King George V. During your journey as a driver on this route, you'll learn to drive this locomotive, as well as the LMS Stannier Class 8F, a freight locomotive. You'll learn to haul a variety of different freight between the bustling yards and perform both express and local stopping passenger services. Learn all there is to know about operating these iconic locomotives in an era when steam was king. Welcome to Train Sim World, Spirit of Steam, Liverpool to Crewe. In this training module, you'll be learning how to drive an LMS Stannier Class 8F steam locomotive in BR Black livery. Stand on the platform and wait for this train to arrive. Today, you'll be taking over this freight service bound for Ditton. This class of locomotive was built between 1935 and 1946 and was designed as a freight version of the highly successful Black 5 locomotive. Climb up onto the footplate to begin. Let's prepare the locomotive for departure. The reverser determines the direction of travel and how much power to apply. Move the reverser into the full forward position. This ensures that you will get the maximum power to get the train moving. As you pick up speed, you will need to move it towards the centre to save power. This locomotive has two types of brakes, steam and vacuum. Steam brakes will apply on just the locomotive. Vacuum brakes will apply to the rest of the train, so long as it is equipped with vacuum brakes. Use the combination brake to apply both types of brakes simultaneously. Vacuum brakes are released when there is a vacuum in the system. To apply braking force, air is added back in by the driver using the combination brake. To create a vacuum, you should use the ejectors. The small ejector should be left open when the train is running. The large ejector can be used to increase the vacuum more quickly after coupling or heavy braking. Open the cylinder cocks to remove any water from cylinders after it has been left standing. Water in the cylinders can damage the locomotive as it does not compress like steam. The regulator acts like the throttle for the steam locomotive. It controls how much steam is delivered to the cylinders. Slowly open the regulator to apply power. Remember that power delivery is delayed in a steam locomotive. Applying too much power too early can cause wheel slip. Now you're moving, you can open the regulator some more. Try not to exceed around 30 miles per hour while you're learning to control this locomotive. You're starting to pick up speed. Move the reverser towards the mid-gear. This reduces the amount of steam let into the cylinder and saves energy. concludes this training module. In this training module, you will learn how to read and react to semaphore signalling. In the top right are the signal and speed limit displays. These feature an indication of what is approaching and a countdown distance to when they will come into effect. Green indicates that you are clear to pass the signal. Yellow indicates that you can proceed, but with caution, as the next signal might be red or there could be a hazard. Red indicates that you should stop and should not pass this signal. Some of these displays can be hidden by the settings menu for a more challenging experience. Now let's look at some of the signals that you will see on this line. There are two principal classes of signals. Home and starter signals. These are mandatory and an approaching driver must stop if the signal displays a danger aspect. Distance signals. These are a warning. An approaching driver may pass the signal displaying a caution aspect, but must be prepared to stop at the following signal. The signal in front of you is currently displaying a danger aspect. That means the line ahead is not clear and you must wait. The signal in front of you is now cleared. However, the next distance signal could display caution, meaning that the following signal will be displaying a danger aspect. Stay vigilant and keep an eye out for the next signal. Proceed when ready. Remember, you can always just look at the heads-up display if you are unsure what the next signal is. includes this training module. In this training module, you'll be learning how to drive an LMS Jubilee class steam locomotive in BR Green livery. This class of locomotive was built between 1934 and 1936 and nicknamed Jubilee after one of its class was named Silver Jubilee. To get started, climb onto the footplate. Take a seat in the driver's position. In this training module, you will be performing passenger operations. You are now ready to depart for West Allerton. The reverser determines the direction of travel and how much power to apply. Move the reverser into the full forward position. This ensures that you will get the maximum power to get the train moving. As you pick up speed, you will need to move it towards the centre to save power. Slowly open the regulator to apply power. Remember that power delivery is delayed in a steam locomotive. This locomotive has two types of brakes, steam and vacuum. Steam brakes will apply on just the locomotive. Vacuum brakes will apply to the rest of the train, so long as it is equipped with vacuum brakes. To create a vacuum, you should use the ejectors. Move the reverser towards the mid-gear. This reduces the amount of steam let into the cylinder and saves energy. Station. Let's prepare the train to slow down. Use the combination brake to apply both types of brakes simultaneously. You can now continue the journey to Mossley Hill. To create a vacuum, you should use the ejectors. Now close the doors and prepare to depart for Edge Hill unguided. That concludes this training module. In this training module, you will learn how to refill the tender with water and coal before coupling up to a set of freight wagons. Firstly, you'll need to prepare the locomotive to receive water. Walk over to the water crane, where you'll need to move the water hose over to the rear of the locomotive's tender. Now the hose is in position, climb up the tender and open the water hatch. Insert the hose into the tender tank once the water hatch is open. The hose is in, and the tender tank is ready to be filled. Turn on the water and start filling the tender tank. Turn off the water and bring the hose back to the water tank before closing the water tank. Now you need to fill the tender with coal. The locomotive is ready to go, but the points in front need switching. These points are manually controlled, so you will have to leave the locomotive and walk to the points. Pull the junction lever to switch the direction of the points. The locomotive is now ready to move. Climb aboard the locomotive and drive it to the stop marker. points into the siding have been set for us. Slowly reverse into the sidings and stop in front of the wagons. To the wagons, climb down from the locomotive and walk to the rear of the tender. The wagons are now coupled and the service is ready to start. Climb back aboard the locomotive and drive to the yard exit to finish the tutorial. concludes this training module.